Dear governments of the world, the coronavirus has unleashed an unprecedented wave of political improvisation. It has also brought to public economic consciousness a particularly painful truth that life-saving can also cause different forms of human deadly harm. So let's take a few important moments to think about our long-term future from the perspective of the last few months, before our memories slowly fade away, visibly a receding level of viral adrenaline. It's certainly too early to say that we are entering a new age of global pandemics, but it's rather certain that we are likely to see more diseases like COVID-19 in the future. And they will keep shaping our human destiny in many diverse ways, good and bad. But what really scares me today is my heartbreaking awareness that this current virus, despite all the statistical noise in the media, wasn't especially lethal, falling rather within the normal range of mild infectious diseases. Let's be honest, there is a real possibility that this time was just a prelude to your future challenges, an opportunity to learn how to be smarter, the worst still to come. Yes, the next pandemic could be even faster and much more deadly, targeting all social and age groups with the same level of intensity. And when it happens, will you respond in an equally chaotic manner? Will you get us so many things unnecessarily wrong again? Will you serve us, your voters, with the same dose of self-inflicted economic devastation? Our global, fast and just-in-time way of living has been painfully tested and proved to be highly fragile. And every problem we've been facing before the pandemic, from economic polarization to environmental pollution, has already got much worse than we could ever imagine. So, to prosper and to feel protected, we need a globally united leadership with one version of planetary reality. We must take a hard human look at all the ways the future pandemics can ruin our private life and our environment. And we have to try to start an open social dialogue, relentlessly empirical, about the financial cost of physical health and emotional well-being. Please remember that solving this global pandemic puzzle by avoiding potentially far-reaching effects from health and food insecurity to social upheaval will be the main driving force behind our election choices for years to come. Yes, mistakes are unavoidable, but next time you have to do much better, and surely there will be a next time. So be proactive, don't use misinformation, and stop managing by fear. We need truth, trust, and hope. Can you handle this?